Hey guys, happy Thursday. It's me, Victor here. Lot on scan for pre-market. ABIO is going to be a top one to watch for a massive short squeeze. Again, they're in relation with the coronavirus sector play. Long-term chart is ideal. It's a nice breakout. Anything's possible with this one. I'm not going to touch it. I'm just going to watch it and hope you learn from it too. Ideally, I mean, this is looking like a cup and handle. I mean, I don't want to short this right away. It is going to be a potential short, but again, it's tied in relation to the coronavirus hot sector play, so it always has possibilities. Okay, so that's the one to watch. Mark, it's kind of, this is going to be a nice overextended gap down pattern. It's the first time in the, again, wait for a trend change. That's what I said in yesterday's video lesson. Today's the first time that it gapped down. That is a trend change. I'm not going to be able to short it because, number one, I'm still in my alt position, but as well, I probably won't be able to get a borrow. But I'll watch it for sure, just to see how it goes. But ideally, never say can go higher. I mean, of course, they have earnings after hours at 4:30 this afternoon. But we'll see. I mean, the fact that a gap down is a major trend change. So perhaps it traps shorts. We'll see what happens. TLSS is an OTC. This is going to be a nice potential watch for a morning panic. I likely won't trade it, but we'll see how this goes. The fact that it faded into yesterday's close kind of foreshadows what's to come today, so we'll see. And again, with these OTCs, the one thing to watch is level two. That's one thing to watch. You see, you have a big bid rate. You want, the bigger the panic, the bigger the bounce will be. But if there's no bounce, then I'll simply put on another stock to watch. But yeah, and as you can see, ABIO is even going further now. I'm not gonna touch this either way, because frankly, I'm not comfortable going long these stocks that move quickly. I'm not saying you can't, that's just me. But yeah, I'm still short alt. I mean, right now it's at 750. It's not that liquid right now. Ideally, I got short into the bounce yesterday. I explained it in the video recap in the 805s and the bounces. Right before close, got short 805. Ideally cover 730s. I don't want to get over aggressive. If it does base, I'll just get out. It's not a coincidence 750 is basing. That's prior resistance, which is now acting as support. So 750 has to crack. We'll see how this goes. Again, this is a sector play, so it always could put out a PR. So I just have to be cautious about that one. But I'm watching it, and we'll see how it goes on that one. But other than that, just focus on A plus setups. And the overall market has been on fire lately because of a lot of traders are coming into the game, and OTCs have been on fire. So we'll see how OTCs go. Again, they open at, well, they don't open till later, but I'll likely see how they go intraday scan. But other than that, I don't need to force anything. I don't need to trade. Just take it one trade at a time and just be patient and trade me. And again, everyone's different as a trader. What works for you may not work for me. That's one of the common questions I always get, is they always say, Victor, what stock should I trade today? And I'm not, if you can't answer that question, you shouldn't be trading, because everyone has their own unique style and it takes time to discover that. But I'm not saying I found it. No, I haven't. I'm still learning. I'm testing. Think of yourself as a scientist. But one more time, TLSS, morning panic watch, dip by, mark potential overextended gap down pattern. If this does go red to green, that's going to be a major shift. I mean, it's only 10 cents away from red to green move. We can see a nice spike off of that. Again, it's in their best interest to hold this up. I say they, because I'm not sure who's behind this, but it's in their best interest to hold this up, because they have earnings tomorrow, today afternoon, and now at 4 o'clock. So we'll see how it goes. I mean, this will collapse eventually. And ABIO, first green day. And other than that, I'm watching GNUS, which you can't really see, which I guess I can show you. This is a nice breakout. There's no specific news to warrant the uptrend. But again, I went over it in yesterday's recap. They have a lot of itchy, nasty information. So we'll see. Ideally, I'll look to short that after alt is done with. But again, I'm not just gonna short it had random prices. I'm gonna short it whenever the price action is suitable to do so. But other than that, happy Thursday, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you. All right, so one more time, TLSS, potential morning panic watch. Mark, it could be a short, but be careful of the green, red to green price action that could lead to a massive short squeeze. Again, I expect it to be very choppy. Ideally, it could have a nice panic. ABIO, anything's possible. Topping action right now, probably fades and dips. But I'm still short alt, and we'll see what happens. But other than that, happy Thursday.